I'm going to be showing you guys how to macro inside of Beesmas as any high roller. Like, I even will be showing you a boosting macro that will be using stingers every couple of seconds and any item you want, really. And same with a pro blue macro. So let me actually start out by searching up Natro macro, and I will leave this link down below in description. And when you guys do actually get over here, then you do want to click this, the latest release. Go down here and download this. Then it should be downloaded. You want to go to today, what you have downloaded, extract all, and it's going to get extracted. Then when you do actually extract it, you do want to just click inside of here, then click start. And as you guys do see over here now, let me actually even go in game as well to show a demonstration and everything. Never mind, it's not letting me. And let's say you are macroing inside a pine tree field, so you do obviously want to have drift comp, because I am pretty sure this actually makes it that in case you are at the edge of the field like this in pine tree and you're about to go out and just macro over here, not in field, it just will go back wherever it detects supreme saturator. So that definitely needs to be enabled. For the pattern shape, I usually myself use squares always, but I do kind of suggest to try out every single pattern to see what you like. Mostly length, I would say medium or large, but mostly medium. Width can be whatever you prefer, but I usually went with like 3, 4, 5 minutes. I would kind of say go for 8 minutes right now, because balloons will deflate after like 10 minutes or so, and you would just come back to the same balloon you would have had like 3, 4 minutes ago. For the pack, you want to have like 100%, 2 hive, walk by hive if you are macroing as blue. This doesn't have to be on over here. Don't even need rotate camera or anything. None. If you are macroing as blue, you do want to have walk by hive. And if you aren't macroing as blue though, and you're macroing just in a different field, going for stickers, just have reset on. The distance, you don't want to have that high distance, so just keep it low. Or else, I mean, you can if you really want to, but that's just if it's going to work for you. Then can go with upper left as well for pine tree, since that's where your alt account's probably gonna be as well, or the people where you're macroing with. But you can obviously experiment and see which one you will like more. Then for the collect and kill, you obviously always want to have clock on, actually. Yeah, if you aren't macroing as blue, make sure to have mondo and kill on, and you always want the loot. For the dispensers, obviously, I mean, you know, glue and everything. And make sure you guys have Beesmas stuff on, like the stockings. This is gonna help you so much. Get new bee equips, honey reef, actually maybe not, feast 100%, gingerbread house not yet, snow machine yes, candles yes, samova, lid art, basically everything you can. And for kill over here, you can have kill vicious bee if you are going for stingers, and you can have this over here, all of these mobs if you are trying to macro for snowflakes and everything. But I don't recommend you have it on while you are macroing as blue, because that's just gonna waste time. For the boost over here, I would actually say auto field boost yes, as it does actually use dice or glitter after you do get pine tree from the blue field booster, which is gonna help you so much. So make sure you have this set over here, 3 field boosters. And you can also just untick all of these over here if you are blue hive, because if you are macroing solo and you don't really have an alt account, I would kind of say to actually macro inside of selected boosted gather fields from the blue field booster, because if you do have it as well on your king beetle over here, you're gonna get even more from it. But I mean, your balloons are gonna be bigger because there's a field boost on the field, and blue flower is kind of crazy. Like, if you think about it, 3 times boost there. You really want to do that. Kind of sad that your alt account won't really go with you, but I'm sure they definitely have that in their private version. But make sure you have that enabled though, not gonna lie, really good feature. Probably will make you more. Can have wind shrine enabled if you want. Sticker stack as well, right before you do get the thing, or just normally. Sticker printer if you do want to as well. Some more stickers, nice, nice, nice. Actually really useful over here. I didn't even realize this existed till right now. For the quests, kind of obvious over here, but we do actually have polar bear, black bear, bucko bee, riley bee, brown bear, and all you have to do is literally just enable it and you'll be good. And this can be done while you are macroing for the quest badge over here for the more capacity, and also while you are macroing for the battle badge for 100% crit power. And this did actually get decreased, both of them by the way, so that's really useful. Then for planters over here, we do actually have a way to even keep up 5 nectars. Now at first I would actually tell you guys to get some nectars before you do start the macro, because it won't really build up that much, it will just keep it up. So at least get some nectars before. And also don't go on this one, I'm not gonna lie, kind of too complicated, so just do manual for now. I don't even know what this is, like it's actually too complicated for me as well. I would just start with, so if you do have petal planter, then go for petal. But if you don't have petal, then just go with the tacky planter as a replacement. But for the petal planter, you do want to have sunflower, then thyme. This is automatically gonna be glitter, but if you do want, if you're not blue, then you can go for that. Then you do want to go with pine tree after, or you can have a blue planter in there if you really want want to, then petal inside of pineapple, and then you can go for petal again or tacky planter once again. And I think it was pumpkin or something, coconut after. Yeah, let's just do that for now. Then for the pesticide planter, 100% pesticide for everyone. You do want spider, and pesticide strawberry, pesticide mushroom, and pesticide in rose. Then after, you do want either red clay, blue clay, or heat treated and hydroponic. So obviously heat treated hydroponic being the better one that you do want to have, but if not, you can either go with blue clay and red clay planter as well. So I'm just gonna go with the better ones for now though. So starting with heat treated right inside of pepper, then going with hydroponic and blue flower, and heat treated once again inside a mountaintop, and then inside of clover field or whatever other field that gives invigorating as well. So if you do that, you'll be good. But also you can actually gather in planter fields. Like currently I am just macroing on my planter of plenty wherever it is. If you aren't actually blue hive and just want to get nectar, or even if you are blue hive and you are struggling with getting nectar, but you can macro, just gather on the planter field and you'll be good. Then this is the status, not much really else, but you can actually have a Discord bot set up. If you do go with change Discord settings, you can put your webhook URL, create your own macro server, and you'll be good with that. Then we have settings over here. I prefer this GUI. Can always have it on top if you want. This is actually important because make sure your hive slot is good. So this is hive slot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like it says on the macro right there. Make sure your hive is fully good. Private server, and with your private server as well, what you do actually want to do is have an actual good server link and not a share code. And if you do actually want to get that, all you have to do is literally just take the server link from over here, paste it inside of Google, then just let it make you join the game, and then from there the entire thing would just show up. Obviously have fallback to public server enabled, move speed correction, get your move speed right, move cannon way, walk cannon, obviously cannon is better, sprinkler type, gather every 30 minutes or whatever you do actually want. I would say just always if you are blue hive, if not then you can just, you know, put it there. And everything else over here is really good, not gonna lie. Like your pattern and everything is your choice mostly, and what you will like most of the time, but me personally, squares is the best for me. And then we do actually have the boosting macro now though. So this is actually a different one because not much other people have actually known about this, but I've been using it in my latest video of me boosting, so make sure to check that out if you haven't yet. But if you do actually want to get it though, over here as you do see, to download it, just get this, then once again go inside of your downloads, extract it so everything is good. Then when you open it over here, you do want to get it for your main, because you can also do it on your alt account, or whoever you're boosting with can use this as well, because it does send the link over here and you'll be good. Also, if you do get this, do not worry, because nothing will happen. Like, I literally have this downloaded, so much other people have it downloaded as well, that I know nothing has happened, so don't worry. Windows just can't see the code, that's why they do it, but it's nothing bad, trust me. And then for this one, let me give you the good settings, because I actually have it on my main PC too. And as you guys do see over here, these are my settings. So for delays, I do actually have stingers in here, so 1.5k, but 15,000, and that's milliseconds. And to even run it, that's what you actually have to press over here. And you can have this for anything. Like, this can even work on your alt account. Basically what it does, it literally just sends like an F or something, and it activates the alt account's macro, and it just sends jelly beans as well at the same time. So it's actually really, really useful. It's definitely been working out for me even when I have been using it, that one boost before, and I will be using it whenever I do switch to white hive as well. But yeah, I hope you guys have really enjoyed this and it has helped you guys a ton. If you still have any questions, I will be answering all of them in the comments too, so please let me know. And yeah, thanks so much for watching, and bye.